हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक द टॉपिक एंड गॉडेस. ओके, सो वी ऑलरेडी आर फेमिलियर विद द ऑप्टिकल टाइप ऑफ एनकोडर फ्रॉम द लास्ट क्लास. एक्चुअली इन आवर सिलेबस एनकोडर आर इंक्लूडेड सेपरेटली. सो टू अंडरस्टैंड एनकोडर्स इन डिटेल वी हैव टू स्टडी दिस टॉपिक. ओके, सो वी ऑलरेडी सीन दैट एनकोडर्स. ओके, वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द ऑप्टिकल एनकोडर इन द लास्ट क्लास. इट इज अ टाइप ऑफ व्हाट? ए सेंसर विच इज यूज टू सेंस द डिस्प्लेसमेंट और मूवमेंट. ओके, it comes under proximity type of sensing. Okay, so with the help of light and a light detector, with the help of a coated disc, actually the encoders are working. So the encoders are devices which produces digital output from linear or angular displacement. What encoders do is actually nothing but it takes either linear displacement or angular displacement. That is, either linear movement or rotational movement can be sensed using this type of device. Okay, so encoders are used to produce digital output. Actually, the benefit of encoder is it already produces a digital type of output from linear or angular displacement. That is, we can sense either linear displacement or rotational displacement using this type of sensor. Okay, so we already seen that in this type of optical encoders, we already seen that there is a coated disc. We already said the disc is coated. Rotary disc will be coated in one form and linear scale will be coded in another form. So depending on the code, we will get a certain type of output in the with the help of light detectors. So when we coming to encoders, by decoding the single or set of bits. Okay, actually with the help of this coded disc, the light, when this LED light always passes, is switched on. So when the disc rotated with a certain cord in it, it will produce a certain pattern on the light detector. That is how the light detector senses and senses that input parameters and produces a digital output. Okay. So I think the basic working is based on this type of coding and decoding. Okay, so I think it is basics is clear how encoder works. So by decoding single or set of bits, bits means just either one or zero. You know, you are already familiar with binary codes. So bit means a message. Okay, or a code that is either one or zero. Okay, so by decoding single or set of bits, the pulses can be converted into relative or absolute. Actually, pulses means the output digital wave is called a pulse. Okay, so as the output from the encoder, by decoding single or set of bits, the pulses can be converted into relative or absolute. Okay, so when we classify these encoders, there are two types of encoders. That is a linear type encoder and a rotary type encoder. We already discussed about a rotary type encoder in that is an optical sensor. Optical encoder we already discussed in last class. That is a rotary type encoder used to sense rotational movement. And another type is nothing but a linear type of encoder. Okay, so we already told, depending on the output pulse, we can classify the encoders as relative and absolute. Absolute means absolute value of linear displacement or angular displacement is measuring here or giving as output. And if the case the output is a relative value of linear or angular displacement, it is another type of encoder. It is called incremental encoder. So the depending on the output pulses, the encoders are classified into two. One is incremental encoder and other is absolute encoder. Okay. In case of incremental encoder, it actually detects the change in rotation from a datum position. Okay. And in case of absolute encoders, it actually gives actual angular or linear position. Okay. So we know that it is just a binary. We are using binary code to represent or read the encoded output. Okay. So both the cases, in case of linear encoder, there are two types, that is incremental encoder and absolute encoder. And in case of rotary encoders also, there is two type. One is incremental and the other is absolute encoder. So in case of linear encoder, if the output signal gives a relative pulse, it is a linear incremental encoder. And in case if the output from a linear encoder is absolute value, then it is called absolute encoder. Okay. I think it is clear. In both the cases, we are using binary code. Okay. Similarly, in case of rotary encoders also, we are getting two types depending on the output produced. And that is incremental rotary encoder and absolute rotary encoder. I think it is clear. Okay. So this is an example for incremental and absolute type of encoders. These two discs, this is just a coded disc. Okay. As shown in our yesterday's example, this green disc is actually represented here. So we can, in detail, we can find what are the difference between incremental and absolute encoders. Okay. Both are used for different purposes. So we can simply understand what are the difference between incremental as well as absolute encoders. I think the difference between linear and rotary encoders are already known to you. Means, as the name indicates, linear encoder means it is used for measuring linear displacement. And in case of rotary encoders, it means it is used for measuring angular displacements. Okay. So coming into linear encoder. Actually, in linear encoders, linear encoder means it can be either incremental or absolute type. So as an introduction to this linear encoder, instead of a rotary coded disc, here it is a glass scale with the opaque gratings. Okay. That is, in incremental encoders, it has transparent scale with the opaque gratings. Gratings means something printed or marked. Okay. So in case of incremental encoders, initially we can see that it has a LED light source. Then it is the light is passed through a condenser type lens. The condenser type lens is used to make the light ray into a straight line. Okay. So in order to make a light ray that is coming from the LED light into a straight line, we are using condenser lens. Okay. So after coming out from the condenser lens, it is actually passes through a scanning reticle, that is actually the glass scale with the opaque gratings. Okay, that is the scanning reticle. That through that scanning reticle, it is actually getting into a photovoltaic cell or array, which is playing a role as a light detector. Okay, here only difference is it is instead of rotating element, we are using a linear element. Okay, linear scale. So that is the only difference here. So this is the basic working principle of a linear encoder. So there are we already told we will get only, you can see here that you can either see a yellow light reaching the photovoltaic cell or there is no light reaching here. That is either light or no light. That means it is either plus signal, that is one, or zero. There is only two types of message reaching at the photovoltaic cell, that is detector. So you will get only a binary code as the output from the encoder. So as I already told, it is just a pulse means digital form of output. So we are already getting a pulse as an output. So there are two types of signals that reaches the detector. That is, one is opaque, that is when these gratings, actually the scale is actually transparent in nature, but these gratings are nothing but opaque in nature. You can see that when the light passes through gratings, there is no light is transmitting. Okay, which means that the gratings are opaque in nature. Okay, so when a light passes through gratings, actually an opaque or black signal is getting at the photo detector. Here it photovoltaic cell. Okay, so if it is passing through a transparent part of that scale, then a color will be there and it is coded as zero. You can in some other cases black is considered as zero, or no means color is light is considered as zero. In both the cases, both are true. Okay, depending upon how they are coding, we will get the result. Okay, there is only one and zero, so we are not getting confused if we take either opaque as one or either color as one. Okay, so the principle of both absolute and linear encoders are similar means it is almost the same. We already told that in absolute type of encoders, it actually gives the absolute value of distance covered at any time. Okay, I think it is clear. That is, in absolute encoder, it actually gives the absolute value of distance covered by the sensor or that particular device. Okay, but in case of incremental encoder, it gives a relative value of distance covered by the device. Okay, so I think it is clear. There is nothing difference in between incremental and absolute on basis of a working principle or a diagram. So you can, if both are asked, you can simply draw this diagram to explain both type of encoders. But the only difference is in absolute encoders, it gives absolute value of distance covered at any time, and in case of incremental encoder, it gives the relative value of distance covered. Okay, so you may get confused if there is no difference in the working principle, how the output are changing. That is, how there is different absolute value and relative value are getting from the same instrument. But at that place, there is a small difference. That is, you will get clear when we discuss about a rotary type of encoder. But for a sake of information, you can simply see that the detect the output of output from the linear encoder the output from the linear encoder will be in form of a certain strips. Okay, so each strip is called a track. So each strip consists of two sensors to get a relative value. Okay, to get a relative value, that is for an incremental encoder, to get a relative value, one track of output is connected with two sensors. But in case of absolute encoders, there is only one sensor for each track. So in case of absolute encoders, we will get only the absolute value, and in case of incremental, we are getting actually the relative value. So that is the major difference between the absolute and incremental encoders. Okay, so when we go to a rotary type of encoder, which we are already discussed in yesterday's class, rotary types of encoders are also classified into two. That is, you only need to consider this part for exam point of view. This is a general classification. Okay, so when you consider a rotary type of encoder, the output signal, that is a rotary, you know, the output signal will be in pulse form. So depending on the output signal, it is classified into two. If it is a relative signal, it is called incremental, and if the signal is absolute, it is called absolute rotary encoder. Okay, I think it is clear. Same classification is also based on linear type encoders also. Okay, so another classification is depending on the sensing technology. Here we are using just a optical type of sensing, that is a light LED source is using here, and a LED means light detector is used here. So the sensing technology used for this type of encoder is optical type here. In some other cases, we can also use laser as well as magnetic type, but optical is only enough for your syllabus. But for understanding what encoders are, we can simply say that there are different types of encoder. The optical is one we are discussing here. Okay, so you can see this is actually the diagram for a linear type of encoder. So if you think there are three types of encoder based on sensing technology, how then, why it is called a encoder, why the name retains there? Why? Because this means that encoder, that word means just to decode, okay, or encode, just opposite words, which means it is using a certain code to work. So here we are using, with the help of optical properties, we are encoding and decoding the parameters. And in some other cases, magnetic properties like attraction or number of means density of fluxes, etc., the coding and decoding may happen. And in laser, maybe it will be in some other way. Okay, so basically encoder means it is just used to encode and decode the parameter to sense it. Okay, so I think it is clear to you. So coming into optical encoders, we can see that a light emitter is placed here and a light detector is placed here. This disc is mounted on the shaft which is to be measured. That is, here we are actually measuring a rotation. Okay, here we are measuring rotation of the shaft. So in order to measure the rotation of shaft, actually the disc is mounted over that corded disc is mounted over that rotating shaft, and from one side the LED emitters are emitting light, and from the other side it is actually detected using lie detectors. So with the using this experiment setup, they are actually measuring the speed of shaft, that is RPM of the shaft. Actually this lie detector produces a certain type of signal as output. I already told it will be a code, binary code. It will be a binary code. You have to understand that code is actually, with the help of logic unit, the code is actually decoded to find the speed in this case and find the displacement in case of linear encoders. Okay. So I think it is clear. So this is actually the absolute encoder. This figure represents the absolute encoder, that is for certain application. For depending on the application, it is different. If you want to find the relative speed, the code will be different. If you want to find the absolute speed, the code will be in another form. Okay. So depending on the application, the code of the disk will be, or that scale in case of linear, the scale will be different. So why it is called the absolute encoder? Why? Because you can see this orange dot, which represents the sensors. That is, at this location, the sensors are positioned. So for in case of rotary encoders, each concentric circle is a track. I think this is first track, and this is second track, and this is third track, and this is fourth track. So in case of a rotary encoder, clearly speaking, absolute rotary encoder, you can see the sensor is only one for each track. Each track has got only one sensor. So you will get only absolute value. Okay. These three are absolute encoders. Okay. And if it was a incremental encoder, means incremental rotary encoder, there will be two set of sensors for each track. Here, there should be 8 sensor for this 4 track. Okay. That is 2 for each track. That is how an incremental or relative encoder work, and this is how a absolute encoder works. Okay. So you can see that this is a binary encoded wheel. You are only getting either white or black, that is either 0 or 1 as output. So the binary code plays an important role in case of encoders. Okay. So to understand what the in detail how it is measuring, I already explained it, but imagine, not this case, imagine if the number of track is 10, here it is only 3. So imagine if the number of track is 10 and the number of position can be detected will be 2 raised to 10. These two comes from the binary nature, either 0 or 1. So the number of positions which can be detected is equal to 2 to the power 10, which is equal to 1024. Okay. So with the help of 10 track disc or a linear scale, we can actually find number of positions as 1024. So we already know the resolution of a device. So the resolution will be 360 by 1024. This 360 comes from 360 degree of a circle. So the 360, you know that angle of a circle, interior angle of a circle is nothing but 360 degree. Okay. So circle 360 degree divided by number of position which can be detected gives the resolution of this type of encoder. Okay. So I think it is clear to you. This is a real life device. This is a corded rotary disc. This is a shaft. This is a capture plate. A light is passing from the right to left, and you are finally getting into a photo detector. This is how a encoder works. But here there are some limitations for encoders. They are normally binary code is generally using. Actually, these encoders in at the initial stage, it was using completely depending upon the binary code. That is, binary coded system is actually using. But in case of binary system, there can be chance of error. Okay. So I'm telling the normal binary code is generally not used here. I will explain it in next topic. Okay. So change from one binary to next result in more than one bit change due to misalignment. This is the limitation of a encoder. General encoder means either rotary or linear type. Okay. So in case of encoders, normal binary code is generally not used here. Okay. Why? Because the change from one binary to next binary code result in more than one bit change due to misalignment. Okay. So coming to gray code, you will actually get why the limitation or how the limitation is overcome by the encoders. Actually, what binary word means is just two. You already familiar with that. That is, unary means one, binary means two, and ternary means three. Okay. So binary code means it just means it is using zero and one. Okay. But logic is different here. Okay. So if you are familiar with the binary code, it is it can be expressed as the power of two. Usually in binary code, decimal, that is in normal counting numbers, zero is represented like this. And in case of binary code, the zero is represented as 0000. Okay. And in case of decimal one, the binary corresponding code is 1000. In this way, you have to see here. Okay. We are actually seeing from right to left here. Okay. So in case of decimal 2, it is actually 01. Okay. And in case of 3, this is 11. And in case of 4, it is 100. And in case of 5, it is 101. This is the actual binary code that we are learning. This is a general binary code. But this code has limitation due to when this number is changing from one point to another, means one value to another, we are actually, there are some cases for the compiler to get a different result or wrong message. So in case of ordinary binary coded system, there is a chance for error to occur. Okay. So in that case, we are actually using gray coded system. We are actually using gray coded system to overcome the limitation of binary coded system. You just keep in mind that during calculation, there are possibility for error to occur in case of binary coded system. So in order to overcome the limitation, the gray code is actually adapted for encoders. Okay, in that case, gray code is actually, it is a binary number system. This is also, gray code is also binary number system. It doesn't mean it is a binary code, it just means it is a binary number system. Okay, you just keep in mind that why it is called binary. It only uses 0 and 1. Okay, it is entirely different from ordinary binary coded system. It is just using 0 and 1. You can see here, in case of gray coded system, you can see only 0 and 1. Okay, and in case of normal binary system, it is logically connected in some way. So in case of gray coded system, you can see that only one bit in the code group is changing. In case of binary coded system, only one bit in the code is changing. That is, you can see corresponding to our zero, actual zero decimal part, it is actually showing zero. In case of one, it is showing one, and in case of two, there is one more, only one digit is changing here. Only one bit is changing here. They add additional one here. Okay. So in order to represent two from one, they are adding just one at this location. There is no logic, but just one is adding at this location. Okay. So, but in case of binary coded system, zero is this, one is this, but in case of two, they are using just logic in powers of 2, that is 2 raised to 0 into 0 plus 2 raised to 1 into 1. That is how they are coding 2 into binary. But here they are just adding one digit additional. Okay, that is how they are getting this as corresponding to 2. Similarly, in case of 3, they are just removing, they are just changing 1 into 0, this 1 into 0. So they are getting 1. So you can see that only one digit or one bit in the code group is changing from 0 to any number. So that is how the gray code is coded. So when research are go means actually as a result of the many research, the gray code is comparatively less error as compared to binary coded system. Okay, that is why the gray code is actually using for encoders. The actual binary coded decimal system is not using here. Actually, the gray coded system is using in case of encoders. So I think it is clear. You just find how the coding is just coded. Okay, there is nothing illogical to understand. Just add one, change only one digit to get the next digit. That is the only logic for getting the gray code. Okay, so this gray code is used when the ordinary binary system fails. Okay, that is the only reason for adapting the gray code. Okay. So our next topic is resolvers. Resolvers is also used to measure the angular position of the lead screw, thereby to measure the position of a machine slide. Usually to find the position of a machine slide, they are actually measuring the angular position of a lead screw. It is a mechanism related to your lathe. Okay, so this resolver is also used to measure the angular position, and the resolver consists of stator and rotor winding, which are mounted at a right angle to each other. Okay, it is somewhat similar to an AC motor. It is similar in construction to an AC motor. So this is the working diagram of a resolver. Here electromagnetic induction is actually happening, and similar to the working of an AC motor. AC means alternating current motor. Okay, So similar to the working of an AC current motor, they are actually getting the angular position. Okay, that is how the solvers are working. If an AC alternating current voltage is applied to one end of the stator coil, a maximum voltage will appear at the rotor coil. When these two coils are in line, and the voltage will disappear for 90 degree phase shift. Okay, so that is how the resolver is working. It is based on the principle of electric motor. Okay. So when the shaft is rotated, they induce the voltage in one rotor coil follows a sinusoidal curve, and the voltage induced in the other follows a cosine curve. So the phase angle depends on the angular position of the rotary shaft. This is the basic working. This is how the sensing of the rotation is taking place. Okay. I think it is clear. Next, moving on to synchros. Synchros is a rotary transformer whose primary to secondary coupling may be varied by physically changing the relative orientation of the two windings. We are manually change for this is the diagram. It is almost similar to that of resolvers. This is the diagram of synchros. So in case of synchros, we are actually primary to secondary coupling is actually taken there, and may be varied by physically changing the relative orientation of the two windings. Okay, so it is also known as Celsian synchros. Another name is there, that is Celsian synchros, and widely used for measuring the angle of a rotating machine. For example, antenna platform. So this is also used for measuring the angle of a rotating machine. Okay, this is also a angular type of sensor. Okay, so the primary winding of the transformer is fixed to the rotor, which is excited by an alternating current. This is the rotor, and this primary winding is fixed, and an alternating current is given to this winding. Due to the electromagnetic induction, this excited rotor alternating current by electromagnetic induction flows in three Y connected secondary windings fixed at 120 degree to each other on the stator. This is how the working of, that is when alternating current passes through this winding due to electromagnetic induction, at these three windings of the stators, induced EMF will be happen, and by measuring the phase shift in the measured voltage, you are actually finding, or we are actually getting the rotation. So I'm winding up here. I think it is clear to you.